Hello everybody, my name is Dennis and you are watching Close to Algo Trading. We continue to go deeper into TFX pipeline as a part of our trading strategy construction. In the last video, we have explored the first four components of the TFX pipeline: example generation, statistic generation, scheme generation, and example validator. Today, we will check the remaining components: transformer, trainer, evaluator, model validator, and pusher. In the end, we will export our model into the Apache Beam pipeline. I know, it is a bit of a step aside from our main topic, but I think it is useful to have a good working pipeline for our models. Unfortunately, it looks like TFX pipeline still has some bugs and some of its components are under construction. But let's talk about everything step by step. In the last video, we validated our data and now we are going to transform it. For that purpose, we will use the TFX component transformer. Transform performs data transformation and feature engineering, which are kept in sync for training and serving. It means we can use the same data transformation function for training and production. Honestly, I have started to explore the TFX exactly because I need this functionality. At this step, we will create a couple of Python files. The first one will contain our constants. As you may see, here I defined a list of numerical features and the labels. The second file contains a preprocessing function. This is a callback function from TF Transform for preprocessing the input data. Here we will perform the data transformation and feature construction. At the moment, I am transforming all numeric inputs features to that score and changing the labels from the -1, 0, 1 to the 0, 1, 2, just because the TensorFlow estimator expects positive values. We will use an estimator in this video, because at the moment TFX works only with TensorFlow estimators. In case you want to use Keras model, you need to use model to estimator API. It seems that in TFX version 0.21, they added the functionality that supports Keras model for the training component. I have also checked the TFX version 0.21 release candidate 0, but it has a broken interactive context functionality. I hope the TFX team will fix all the problems soon and we will get a working tool. Okay, let's perform the data transformation. As you may see, the transform components expect the following parameters as input: the generated examples, data scheme, and the path to the file with the preprocessing function. There are our transformed data. You can see that the output contains only the dataset of transformed features. After the data transformation is finished, we will create and train our model. We will use the trainer component for training the model that we will define in the next step. So, now we are going to create a Python file that contains our model and the input functions. As you can see, we defined a trainer fn function. This function will be called from the trainer component. Before training, the executor will call that function, which should return the following dictionary: estimator. The estimator is to be used by TensorFlow to train the model. Train spec. The configuration is to be used by the train part of TensorFlow train and evaluate call. Evaluation spec. This configuration is to be used by the evaluation part of the TensorFlow train and evaluate call. And evaluation input receiver function. This configuration is to be used by the model validator component when validating the model. As you may see, for the training and evaluation steps, we have defined the same input function. Input fn. This function generates the input features and labels. Actually, here we have defined the input functions for different use cases. The example serving receiver function builds the serving inputs. Evaluation input receiver functions builds everything needed for the TensorFlow model analysis. All these functions I took from the Chicago example notebook, and they are working well with the TensorFlow estimators. We have also defined a build estimator function. In this function, we have defined our input feature set and created our estimator. Here I use DNN Linear Combined Estimator. Because the DNN classifier and DNN estimator are generating an error that says that we are passing feature from the TensorFlow 1. That is not the case, because we are using the methods from TensorFlow 2. I could not find a solution for it. But with the linear estimator, it works fine. So we can train our model. Oh, before we train the model, I want to say some words about the using of Keras models and why it is not the best idea if you want to perform a model analysis later. In the Keras model builder function, we define a Keras model which takes our transformed features as input. Then, as TFX guide says, we need to transform our model to an estimator. I am doing it in the build estimator Keras model function. So far so good, we can train our model. But there is a couple of problems. First one appears in the function example serving receiver. As you remember, it is the function for serving inputs. Just from the beginning, we remove the labels from our raw dataset and transform our features. After we run the transform function, the transformer, due to our poor implementation, generates labels again. Those new labels have to be removed from the transform dataset one more time. Because if we leave the labels there, we will get an error. The reason for that is that Keras model expects exactly the same names and counts of input features as defined in the model. Maybe it was not a good idea to make a label transformation to begin with, but it works with estimator. The next problem is the evaluation input receiver function. The training component will execute the evaluation input receiver function, which prepares everything for the model analysis. And here we get the same problem as earlier. The input features don't match with the Keras input. To solve it, we can drop all raw features and labels and keep only the transformed features, so that the input will match to the Keras model input. But in this case, we will not be able to use all functions of TensorFlow model analysis. But let's speak about it later. Now, let's train our model. As you can see, the trainer component expects a module file which contains trainer function as input. Also, it expects other parameters such as transformer examples, data scheme, transform graph, training and evaluation arguments. Here we defined only the number of steps for training and evaluation. Well, after the model training is finished, we can analyze it. To do that, we will use the TensorFlow model analyzer. Before we go further, please check this link and install TFMA. In other case, you will not be able to see any graphs. The model analysis is an interesting topic itself, but I will not stop here for long. Just a few words. We can perform a common analysis on all dataset, or we can analyze a specific feature. My problem here was that the overall analysis is working with both an estimator and Keras model. But if you want to make an analysis based on a feature slice using the Keras model, it will not work, because TensorFlow model analysis makes slices from raw features, whereas Keras input expects only transformed features. It could be that I don't really understand how it works. If some of you know better, I will really appreciate any tips in comments to this video. Okay, let's make an analysis on three slices: complete dataset, our labels, and two features. You can see that we have a perfect accuracy of 98%. But let's check how our model performs according to labels. Well, we can see that our model didn't learn anything. The model just always predicts label 0. It was clear because we have unbalanced labels and we didn't put any useful features in our model. But with the TensorFlow model analyzer, we can easily check how our model performs. Also, if we trained a couple of models, we could compare and show the performance of our models on the graph. The next step in our pipeline is the model validator. It is a TFX pipeline component that helps us validate our exported models. ensuring that they are good enough to be pushed to production. Model Validator compares new models against a baseline, such as the currently used model, to determine if they are good enough relative to the baseline. It does so by evaluating both models on an evaluation dataset and computing their performance on metrics. If the new model's metrics meet developers' specified criteria relative to the baseline model, for example, accuracy is not lower, the model is blessed, marked as good, indicating to the pusher that it's okay to push the model to production. The last component is pusher. Pusher checks whether a model has passed validation and, if so, push the model to a file destination. At the end of this notebook, like in the Chicago taxi example, we will export our components into the Apache Beam pipeline and pack all the files to the zip archive. Then we can unpack all files from the archive to our working directory on the server and execute the pipeline. After the execution is finished, we will have a model that we can use with the TensorFlow serving. The video how to start and use the TensorFlow serving from the Docker container you can also find on my channel. Well, it was a long run. We have checked how the TFX works and understood how to use it for our tasks. It needs to be said that the current version still has a lot of restriction and it may be not a good choice for us. Maybe it will be good enough for us just to make an implementation of the pipeline that use only transformation function with Keras model. So, I hope it was interesting for you. In the next video we will come back to our main goal, trading strategy. Don't forget to comment, subscribe and like this video. See you in the next one. Bye!